I'm Ray, welcome to Wine Tap Tips. Now, a big part of wild wine life is that there's more to wild game than fried sausage. Tonight, we're going to talk about one of my favorite dishes, and that's a port wine demi glaze reduction sauce to go over your venison steaks, elk, or whatever you might want to place it on. This was taught to me by Tony Marino of Tony Marino's Catering years ago. So if you want your catering needs to be taken care of, I highly recommend Tony Marino because he's the guy who taught me this wonderful recipe. You start off with a cup of your favorite port. And I've always said, use something that you would want to drink. So I have a cup of port, some reconstituted dried blueberries. Now you can use cherries, you can use whatever you wish to use. Tonight I'm using some chanterelles that I reconstituted. And on another episode, we'll show you how to dry mushrooms. You can also use morels. We're coming up into morel season and morels are wonderful for this. One chopped up shallot. Tony told me a pinch of sugar, a pinch of salt, and a pinch of pepper. I like a spoonful of sugar. And you can tweak this to whatever you wish to do. Then one tab of butter and one thing of demi glaze. You start off by turning on your oven and your saucepan. Pour your port in. And you let it reduce in half. Now once you reduce it in half, that's when you will add demi glaze. While you're reducing your port, I personally like to put my shallots in to cook them a little bit more. So while the port's reducing down, I'm going to put in the shallots. Then I add the demi glaze. Stir it until it melts. And it never hurts to have a little sip of Cabernet Franc. That's what I'm drinking tonight, is a little bit of Calcu Cabernet Franc. Cabernet Franc is one of my favorite varietals to go with wild game. It's actually one of the wines I will be drinking tonight with this dish. Now that the demi glaze is melted, we add a little bit of butter, and that's going to add a nice little sheen. If you want a little bit more of a nutty flavor, a little bit more vanilla, go ahead and use a tawny. If you want more of a chocolate, more red fruit flavors, use a ruby port. Use what you like, but once again, go with a port that you would drink. Once your butter melts, go ahead and grab your little spices. Very simple, like I said, sugar, salt, pepper. Never hurts to enjoy a nice little sip of Cabernet Franc. That's one of the many things I love about doing this. Next, add your dried blueberries. Now, you can reconstitute them in water. What I generally do is I reconstitute them in the same port that I'm using for the sauce. And then I drain the port off and pour that into the measuring cup for what I'm going to use to cook with. And then after you have your blueberries in, your chanterelles. Gently stir. Thank you.
steaks out, and excuse me for one moment. Now, on another episode, we will show you how to cook your venison steaks, or steaks in general. But for now, we're just going to do the sauce. So you take your sauce, and you just gently pour it over your venison steaks, and enjoy. Now, for those of you who might want to try something different, another wonderful wine that will work with venison is Norton. Norton, I've seen, hold its own up against some of the top Napa wines and Sonoma wines out there. Norton is absolutely delicious with wild game and lamb. You will find that it's enjoyable. Adam Pook de Norton is a killer wine. I'm Ray. Thank you for joining us, and here's to living the wild wine life.